Hi, we're on the search appearance settings for Yoast SEO. In this screencast, we'll focus on the first tab called General. You'll find three different sections here, indicated by three different headings, called Title Separator, Homepage, and Knowledge Graph and Schema.org. First of all, you can choose the Title Separator. The Title Separator determines what we use to separate different parts of your SEO title from each other in the search results. At Yoast, we tend to use this bullet between, for instance, the site name and the title of a page. Let me show you what it looks like in the search results. Let's Google keyword research Yoast. Okay. If you look at the first result, you'll see the bullet appear between the name of the post, keyword research for SEO, the ultimate guide, and the site name, which is Yoast. Of course, you can also use dashes or pipes or something else. What you choose depends mostly on taste, but if you choose a longer one, like this M dash, the amount of space that you have for your title shrinks by the space that a title separator takes up in your title. So, we usually recommend picking a shorter one, like dots or a pipe. The problem that we have with a pipe is that it looks too much like the letter L. Now, let's move on to the second section called Homepage. What can we do here? Let's click the question mark to find out more. This is what shows in the search results when people find your homepage. This means this is probably what they see when they search for your brand name. Okay, so what you can do here is change the SEO title and meta description of your homepage. As we've seen before, you can use snippet variables to determine the SEO title. In our case, the SEO title of the homepage would say Yoast, our site title, then a page number if there is any, our page, a bullet, our separator, and SEO for everyone, our tagline. You can easily adjust the SEO title by clicking Insert Snippet Variable. And you can always check which variables are available by clicking Need Help and then Snippet Variables. In the next field, you can enter the meta description for your homepage. You can insert snippet variables here as well, if you like. Now, let's have a quick look at our own homepage snippet. Let's just Google Yoast. Now here it is, just below the ad. If people click this result, they will land directly on our homepage. Now as you can see, we've customized our SEO title a bit. Instead of showing the site title Yoast first, we've chosen to first show the tagline SEO for everyone. And our meta description explains in one clear sentence what we do and which products we offer. The last section on this tab is called Knowledge Graph and Schema.org. That sounds rather difficult. Is it? Well, no, not for you, because we take care of the difficult stuff for you. Let's first discuss the Knowledge Graph. What is it? A Knowledge Graph panel in Google search results appears when you search for an organization or a person. If I search for example, Walt Disney Company, this panel at the right is the knowledge panel. And if I search for Walt Disney only, this is the knowledge panel. Within the plugin, you can change the settings that will determine what shows up here, which logo shows, and which social profiles show in this panel. You first have to determine whether you're an organization or a person. If you're an organization, you can set a name and logo here. The social profiles, like Facebook and Twitter, are taken care of in the Tools section of Yoast SEO, and we'll come back to that later in this course. If you're a person, you have to select the one that represents the site. Make sure that the user profile information is up to date, as this information will be used in the search results. You can edit this information by clicking this link. We'll come back to that later in this course as well. And, cool, you can also upload an image for persons. What happens next? Well, we will automatically generate so-called JSON-LD metadata You don't have to know exactly what this is right now, but we show this data on the front page of your site. So you won't see this anywhere on the design of your site. This will just show in the code, and it might show up in the search results. Good luck, and don't forget to hit Save Changes, of course.